State Minister for Finance and Civil Supplies E. Rajender announced the distribution of bonds of Farmers Insurance Scheme, stated to be the first of its kind scheme for farmers in the country. Participating at a review meeting on Farmers Insurance Scheme, Kanti Velugu, Land Record Purification and other schemes in Karimnagar town on Saturday, the minister said that the Ritu Bima bond papers would be distributed to the farmers in the villages from Monday. He said that the insurance coverage of farmers would be applicable from 14th of August midnight. Under the scheme, if any farmer dies a natural death or accidental death, his or her nominee would get Rs. 5 lakhs. He said that they would cover all farmers who were benefited under the Ritu Bandhu scheme. The authorities of Municipal Corporation of Karimnagar are taking all measures to ensure 24/7 supply of drinking water in some parts of Karimnagar town by Dasara in October as a part of the Smart City program. Accordingly, the authorities were replacing the old iron and cement pipelines and replacing them with HDPE pipelines to check leakages. Daily water supply has been launched in Housing Board Colony on experimental basis as a part of the measures to provide 24/7 water supply. Round-the-clock water supply would be provided to Housing Board Colony, Rampur and Gautami Nagar reservoir limits in the town. Officials are chalking out strategies to conduct trial run in the first week of October and launch the scheme from Dashera onwards. Also, water supply would be made only after fixing the bulk flow water meters to check the misuse and wastage of water. MCK authorities have also taken up special campaign for providing tap connection at the rate of only Rs. 1 to reduce non-revenue water, which was around 35% in Karimnagar town. All India Congress Committee President Rahul Gandhi will be in Hyderabad on 13th and 14th of August. He'll stay at Harit Plaza next to Pragati Bhavan, where Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao resides. During his two-day tour in the city and Ranga Reddy district, Mr. Gandhi will participate in the fourth phase of Jan Chaitanya Bus Yatra of Telangana Congress and address street corner meetings covering several constituencies in the city and a neighbouring Ranga Reddy district. Since this will be his first visit to Telangana after assuming charge as AICC president, Telangana Congress is making all efforts to ensure that he leaves behind a mark that would haunt the government till the elections. The residents of Sachivale Nagar in Vanasthalipuram will have new experience from now on when they go for a morning or evening walk in their colony park. Under its initiative to come up with improved facilities at colony level, the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation has laid a walking track at Sachivale Nagar based on the theme Acupressure. Adding to the serenity of the park, the aesthetically designed track in the park is laid around a point which is in the middle and has a Buddha sculpture. The new concept of going in for acupressure is based on Panchatattva, the five elements of nature, that is earth, water, air, fire and sky. The circular track has representations of these elements interspersed with the walker having to tread upon one after another. The move comes in the wake of Municipal Administration and Urban Development Minister K.T. Rama Rao's directions to the Municipal Corporation to develop innovative and theme-based parks in the city. Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao on Saturday urged Prime Minister Narendra Modi to arrange a grant of 20,000 crore from the Government of India for Kaleshwaram project. Thanking Mr. Modi and central government for all statutory clearances for the project, Chief Minister said that while the total project cost was over 80,000 crore, the state government had so far spent 25,000 crores and tied up loans totaling 22,000. The Chief Minister said that their objective is to complete this project without any time and cost overruns. Availability of required financial resources will ensure early completion of the project. The reorganization of the districts from 10 to 31 in the state, CM said that 21 of these did not have Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalayas and asked the center to grant them to the state. Under the Safe City initiative, 4 lakh surveillance cameras out of a proposed 10 lakh have been installed in different parts of the city. About 50% of Telangana's gross state domestic product comes from Hyderabad, and there is a need to ensure high standards of safety and security in the city. Surveillance cameras were handy in detection of crime. According to a report of Ministry of Home Affairs, the crime rate in Telangana, especially in the capital, has come down drastically. In fact, the ministry has complimented the Telangana police for its good work. State Minister for Finance and Civil Supplies E. Rajender said that the Kanti Velugu program to be launched on 15th August will help address problems related to vision-related issues across the state. Telangana government has decided to test eyes of every individual under Kanti Velugu program. The minister conducted a review meeting on Kanti Velugu and farmer insurance along with MLCs, MLAs, MPPs, ZPTCs, collectors, agricultural officials, medical officials, tehsildars and other public representatives. The 5.5 months long screening program will start from 15th August and will continue up to January 26. A total of 799 medical teams have been appointed and 100 buffer teams have also been recruited. The minister appealed to public representatives to camp in rural areas and cooperate with the teams to complete 100% screening. President Ram Nath Kovind on Sunday addressed the 7th convocation of IIT Hyderabad at its campus in Kandi. Over 600 students attended the convocation where the president presented medals and degrees to meritorious students of the institute. Addressing the students, President said that the best scientific universities and institutions are not just teaching shops, but are sources of innovation and incubators of technology and technology-driven startups. President called on the students to dream big, aim high and contribute for the benefit of society at large. He also said that IIT Hyderabad has to remain relevant for the fourth industrial revolution.